Pastor Flight Academy Kicks, aka Pastor Flight, Sugar Flight, Flex, Luger, Surf Flight, Flight Gotti, all them good names that I got, you know, y'all know my alias, man. You know, your boy really been doing it big lately, man. And, man, look, man, we're back with another video for y'all, man. And this time, I got something special I want to do. I got a little task ahead of me, man. About to clean up these zebras, right? So y'all know I'm always telling y'all about Rejuvenator and the great products that they got. Listen, if you don't already, at this video, I hope that you see what I'm be trying to tell y'all when I say Rejuvenator is good when it comes to cleaning your kicks, keeping them fresh, you know what I'm saying? They got some of everything, and I got a whole box of goodies right here, you know what I'm saying? Just nothing but Rejuvenator products. I love them, man. So look, man, the link for Rejuvenator is going to be in the description box. So go ahead, you know what I'm saying, click on the link, you know, order whatever you need to. Use my code Flight Academy. Once again, use my code Flight Academy. Save that 10% off at checkout, man. And I'm getting up with good reviews from the people that have been purchasing. So if you haven't already, man, make sure you join the crew and make sure you go and purchase some items, man. You know what I'm saying? It's very, very important that when it comes to kicks, you got to keep them clean. You got to keep them stored nice. They got something for everything. Whatever you're going to need, they got it, man. But I think it's important. Let me go ahead and jump right into the video and talk with y'all about what we're going to be doing today. So I got a pair of Zebra 350s, man. As y'all can see, these Zebra 350s have been through the trenches and back. You know what I'm saying? They done been, they done walked through Jerusalem. Now, as you can see, these are small zebras. They are not my zebras. You know what I'm saying? These are my wife's zebras. And I don't know if she don't really just know about kicks like that, but y'all know how it is, man. Women don't really pay attention to kicks. They pay attention more to like heels and makeup and stuff. But these zebras ain't even a year old. You know what I'm saying? Y'all see, they done been through a fight. These zebras done been in Desert Storm. You know what I'm saying? Like, they all ran through. So I'm going to try and bring these things back to life. You know what I'm saying? Try to bring them back to that DS. You know what I'm saying? Or PADS. You know what I'm saying? But I'm ready to get into it, man. Like I said, we're gonna do some. I got my work cut out for me, but you know what I'm saying? I trust in Rejuvenator. We're going to come together and we're going to make this thing happen. So we're going to bring some life back to this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean one shoe and I'm going to leave the other shoe unclean so you can see it. All right? So get started. We're going to take the shoe strings out. You know what I'm saying? There's no need to have a pure white shoe if the strings ain't white. You know what I'm saying? I never understood that. Should be white as Clorox. Well, Clorox really ain't white, but you know when Clorox touch something, it turns it white. And then the strings be all dingy, man. So, I'm about to take these bad boys out. Now the strings, you know what I'm saying, I'm going to throw. I'm in the washing, you know what I'm saying? Gotta keep the strings on. I ain't gonna do nothing else different to them. So it's kind of hard to take out, man. Man, I should do a tutorial on how to unscreen your zebras, bro. God, oh. Let's do it. I'm just thinking in my head, I gotta do all this to take these out. Man, having to screen these things back in. So, Flight Academy tutorial on how to unscreen zebras. Just cut the strings loose. Just chop them out of there. Man, for the last one, get you a part of here. It's out. There we go. These zebras look kind of weird without the strings in them, but y'all see it, man. So, first thing we're going to do is my selection of brush, all right? So here, I got the soft bristle, right? I'm going to use the soft bristle on the upper of the Action Zebra, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to go with the hard bristle on this type of prime knit material because I don't want to tear it up. You know, the bristle brush on these Rejuvenator brush are serious. When they tell you the bristle is hard and stiff, it means exactly what it says. So you want to pay attention. So this is the stiff bristle, and this is the soft, you know what I'm saying? I can get real good and gritty with it, you know what I'm saying, on the actual prime knit part. Then when you got the stubborn stains, because this part gets closer to the ground, you definitely want to use the stiff one, you know what I'm saying? You see it there? Stiff brush, man. Definitely use the stiff brush on this part. Soft brush up top, man. So first thing you got to do is get you some shoe trees from Rejuvenator, man. Now, here's the thing with that, right? I like this because they can fit any size. You simply just pinch these out. They got little hole pockets that they go in, and you just kind of, you know, find a size. And I wear size 14. Y'all know size 14 game. And they go well in my shoe, you know what I'm saying? So they fit well in my size 14. Pretty sure they can fit well in any of y'all's sizes because some of y'all don't wear the size I wear. All right, so I'm going to have to bring this in a little bit. And what I'm doing is I'm putting the shoe tree in here pretty tight, right? But the reason I'm putting it in here tight is because I want to make sure that the material sticks out. So you see how it's very stiff, stretching the material out. So I want to make sure that when I'm cleaning, I'm getting in between the grooves real good. That's a good thing about having the shoe tree. So I'm going to have the shoe tree in here. Now, for cleaning, you want to get you a good little bowl. For me, I have the Rejuvenator Collapse Bowl. Pretty dope bowl. Once I'm done with it, I can just squeeze it back, slide. Don't take up much space at all. And then we're going to put in that Advanced Sneaker Solution because that's exactly what these shoes need. You know what I'm saying? They definitely need them, man. So I'm just going to take a little bit of the Advanced Sneaker Solution, and I'm going to pour it into... All right, so the first thing you want to do is make sure the top is off.
Nigga!
And peel this off. I didn't really think that part through. It's a brand new bottle. So I'm going to open it. And now we get the pouring. So I'll just dibble dabble a little bit here. Huh? And like I told you last time I did one of these videos, man, you know what I'm saying? You can measure it, put them on the brush, but you know, I like to use the grandma remedy. We just pour it till we think it's enough. You know what I'm saying? You can never go wrong with it. All right. Hey, we're going to get this thing cracking, man. So, starting right with the soft bristle, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to dip it in the bowl, you feel me? Uh-huh. Get that thing good. Get the thing swirly. All right. Let's get to work, man. So, what you want to do is get this thing in a circular motion. You feel me? I'm talking about circular, you know what I'm saying? Like, you got to use the water whip, you know what I'm saying? Make some hurricane designs on the shoe. Huh? And dip it back in the brush if you need to. You know what I'm saying? At your own discretion, you know what I'm saying? Do what you need. Oh, definitely. And as y'all can see, y'all see the sudge on that. You know what I'm saying? Y'all see it sudging up. So, you know, it's getting that dirt that's on there. Getting that dirt. Why everybody make this face when they be scrubbing something? That's the face you gotta make. That's how you know you're cleaning it good, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Look up in that. I didn't get me a pair of these. I ain't got a pair of 350s, man. I didn't get me a, cop me a pair, you feel me? Yeah, yeah. See, I'm liking how they looking already, you feel me? I'm liking how they look already. Suck this bad boy up. Look at that sud, man. Come on, man. We cleaning shoes over here. Fly Academy Dry Cleaner Service. Clean y'all shoes for y'all for a good $50. Oh, God.
Oh, you are so dumb. You are really dumb. For real.
I done dropped the shoe and all. It's all good. Back up. Anybody can do this, man. You know what I'm saying? Kids, whoever, man. You ain't gotta use a lot of strength. You ain't gotta be the world's strongest man to do this. Like anybody can actually do this, man. Scrub it up.
Yeah.
So it's up. Now, let's go to that bottom part. That part that be touching the ground, man. That's what we wanna get on. So, like I told you, I'm using the stiff brush for the bottom. You may want to wear some goggles, you know what I'm saying? But this thing sure do kick up. So, same thing, gonna use that elbow grease on these. Get your good scrub. Now keep in mind what kind of souls these is, you know what I'm saying? So they ain't gonna get back like that, but they're gonna definitely give it that fresh look again, you feel me? And as you can see, like I said, sudging is important, man. Y'all see it, man. Gotta make sure it suds, man. And see it, man. Suds in it. And do the other side as well. You get a good circle of motion on it. Like I said, it ain't hard. Anybody can do it. Shoes don't stop there, but just off rip, man. Like, just to show y'all the one side, bro. Like, it looks so much better than when we started, man. And like I said, this is just me doing the basic cleaning on it, you know what I'm saying? Because as you know, you could throw it in the sneaker laundry as well, man. You know what I'm saying? Throw it in the laundry, use this to get an extra boost. But this just simply off of scrubbing, didn't even take that long. See the size look real good, man. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, they ain't gonna be back to the DF's look, but compared to what they look at now, man, like, boy, look at that, bro. It's a big difference, man. You know what I'm saying? Big difference on them, man. So I got that brightening back. So, and of course, you know what I'm saying, it's wet, so it's gonna get the real good color once it actually dries up. You know what I'm saying? It's pretty damp right now. But I'm just simply wiping the shoe off right now. Simply wiping it off. Like how they look. Like I said, you definitely want to put your strings in the washer. And you can use the strings. If you put these in the bag, you can put these in your laundry bag. You feel me? Throw the strings in there too. Like I said, get the sneaker laundry. Go to work with it, man. Go to work with it. But yeah, man. Zebras, man. Got that white back in them, man. They had all brown and stuff, man. All jacked up. So we back with it, man. So I just want to show y'all, that's just basic steps on it, man. And I'm going to keep making more videos on it, just showing y'all more advanced, giving y'all more up close, man. We're going to do different scenarios as well. Because like I said, Rejuvenator cleans for anything, man. Anything, bro. You know what I'm saying? Whatever you need, bro. You know what I'm saying? From the Timberlands to suede shoes to prime knits on the 350s, NMDs, all my Jordans, I use nothing but that. And as well as, you know what I'm saying, you can use the deodorizer. Spray it in your shoe after you don't clean it up, you know, freshen the shoe up with the inside as well. Gotta make sure the inside clean as well as the outside clean. So you don't want to leave it hanging, man. So go to the link in the description box, man. Like I said, get whatever you need. They got the brushes, they got the bowl, the shoe trees, the sneaker laundry detergent, you know what I'm saying? This is the cleaner that I use. Your water stain repellent. Real good for these right here, trust me. I had one of my subscribers hit me up and told me, like, yo, I'm glad I listened to one of your videos and put this water stain repellent on it. Because, I don't know if y'all remember in the video I was joking about, like, y'all gonna be at cookouts. Y'all know if y'all don't spray y'all shoes down, some of the kids gonna walk by and drop something on y'all shoes. Lo and behold, you was at a cookout, spill something on the shoes, wipe it right off with the Rejuvenator water stain repellent. So go ahead on there and cop something, man. And check out, use code FLIGHTACADEMY, save 10% off, man. You will not regret it. And when y'all purchase it, man, send me a screenshot, man. I'll definitely shout y'all out, man, for supporting the brand, bro. You know what I'm saying? I will never support something that I don't stand by. I'm telling you, this is Fight Academy approved Rejuvenator. So this is just a simple clean I did on the Zebras, you know what I'm saying? It's so much more advanced I can get with these. But I'm going to say that for you for a later time in another video, man. But y'all know what it is, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel, man. Make sure y'all hit the like button. Share, you know what I'm saying? If y'all ain't sneaker group, share the video on sneaker pages. Share it on your IG, man. tell people to hit me up, man. You know what I'm saying? The link is in the description, rejuvenator.com, man. Use code Flight Academy. But until next time, y'all know the slogan, man. Take flight with the flies, man, if you ain't flying with me. This ain't flying right, and we out. And y'all know the motto for the year? Hustle and motivate. Long live Nip, man.
It's all I'm trying to do. Hustle and motivate. Choppers and throwaway.